Welcome back to the Most News in the Morning. 40 minutes past the hour right now. They show talent on the court, but some teams competing in the NCAA tournament this year have a real problem when it comes to academics. A new report reveals that a dozen teams have graduation rates below 40%.
And when it comes to African-American players, that falls to 20% or less on 5 men's teams. Our Kate Baldwin joins us live from Washington this morning, where some people are saying these statistics are pretty shocking, and they're calling for higher standards. It is really surprising, Kate, when you look at this.
Oh, it really is, and it's definitely getting some attention. Good morning, John and Kieran. The start of the NCAA basketball tournament means it's that time of year again when sports fans get a little crazy, but it's the surprisingly low graduation rates of some of these teams that may make people even crazier, and it's grabbing the attention of the Obama administration. Now, the NCAA says it shares the concern over low graduation rates, but also say in a statement, quote, imposing a ban on Duncan about exactly how the Department of Education can implement and enforce this proposal. He said they can't, John and Kieran. He said this isn't going to be a federal mandate of any kind. He says this is really a goal to raise awareness on the issue, and it looks like he has.
Yeah, I was reading your story before the show, and I was startled at my own alma mater, Maryland, 8%. And Gary Williams is really, he's the coach there. He's really pushing back against those numbers. He said this year, four out of their 4 seniors are going to graduate, and most recently, 10 out of 12 did. He said that since these numbers came out back in 99 to 2002, they've made some big changes. But really, it's startling to think 8%.
It is, and one of the things Gary Williams said and other coaches have criticized is that these are old numbers, they say, old data. But the author of the study, I spoke with him yesterday, and he says that that's why they used 4 consecutive classes. They followed them from when they entered school to when they graduated, and that's why the last class graduated in 2009. That's the last complete bit of data. It's 4 consecutive classes, and he says that shows a pattern, not a fluke, which one year would prove. So he stands by the data that he uses. But yeah, the coaches are definitely very sensitive on this issue. They're really trying to protect their players, especially at this very important time of the season.
Yeah, big topic of discussion, a very important time. Kate Baldwin for us this morning. Kate, thanks.
Thanks, guys.
They're keeping a close eye on the Red River this morning. Rob Marciano is